Good afternoon, and welcome to Bentley University. My name is Iris Berdrow, and I will serve as today's ceremonial marshal. It is my pleasure to call to the lectern the chair of Bentley's Board of Trustees, Paul Condren, member of the class of 1983, and a parent of children from the classes of 2019 and 2022.
Good afternoon. It is my honor to call to order the 48th commencement exercises of the Bentley University McCallum Graduate School of Business. On behalf of the Board of Trustees, administration, faculty, and staff, we are gathered here to recognize and celebrate the accomplishments of our graduate and PhD scholars and welcome them as the newest members of the proud Bentley alumni family. I also want to acknowledge the newest double Falcons who will earn a second Bentley degree today. A round of applause for them. Class of 2023, Bentley is excited to celebrate you this afternoon, and we hope you'll return to campus often and maintain a strong connection with the university. We are proud of you and cannot wait to hear about the amazing things you will achieve.
Thank you, Chair Condren. Now, if able, please rise for the invocation and remain standing for a performance of America the Beautiful by one of our PhD graduates and a professionally trained opera singer, Janai Duane. I call to the lectern Father Ted Brown, Bentley University's Catholic chaplain, to offer this afternoon's invocation.
Let us be at prayer. Blessed are you, God, who blesses us with scholars and experts to help us navigate life's challenges. Today, we celebrate these graduates' achievements and recognize the hard work and dedication that has brought them to this moment. We acknowledge that their intelligence is not artificial, but the product of long hours spent studying, researching, and developing skills. We celebrate their resilience in the face of a pandemic and their persistence in overcoming the many obstacles that brought them to this point. May these graduates commit to using their knowledge and skills to impact our world positively. We recognize that each of them is a gift to society, and their ability to delve into the issues of our day will be invaluable as we as a society move into the future. Give them grateful hearts for all those who have supported them along the way. We ask that they recognize the sacrifices made by their families who have supported them financially and emotionally throughout their studies. We also ask that they be thankful for their friends who have been a supportive strength and support during challenging times, and when needed, pointed out when they were just a bit too full of themselves. Help this class appreciate the faculty who have guided them to this moment. Let them be thankful for the hard work and dedication of readers, editors, and all who have assisted with rewrite after rewrite. Strengthen them to live up to Bentley's motto, "Be a force for good." May they use their education to positively impact our world, to create spaces where everyone has an opportunity to succeed and feel respected for their work. Let them use their skills to find innovative ways to use artificial intelligence for the benefit of humanity, to help us find solutions to climate change and guide us through changing economic circumstances. We ask that you give them the courage to face each challenge confidently, knowing that Bentley has prepared them well. We congratulate these graduates and ask that you bless them with success in their future endeavors. May they go forth from this university committing to making a world where we all can flourish. Blessed are you, God, who blesses us with new scholars and experts to help us navigate life's challenges. Amen.
You may be seated. I call to the lectern Ahmed Amer, a member of the McCallum Graduate School of Business, class of 2023, to offer a graduate reflection.
Welcome. President Kreit, trustees, esteemed guests, faculty, staff, parents, family, and friends of my fellow graduates. First and foremost, I would like to thank the members of my class for choosing me to represent them on this special occasion. Because of the honor you have bestowed upon me, I humbly stand here today, and thus I hope to live up to your expectations. To arrive at this point, this class has traveled a rocky road, set off by a pandemic that disrupted our graduate school experience and prevented us from building enduring memories that we would have enjoyed sharing together. Nevertheless, this journey has made us better leaders, more prepared for the unsettled world and the shaky economy waiting for us. I could be standing here talking about the challenges that I faced and how good I was in tackling them all. However, having known most of you closely, I realize that my story cannot compare to yours. But knowing that my children are among the attendees somewhere here, I don't know where they are. I realize that we all share a common fact. We are surrounded by many people who consider us heroes and role models. They look up to us and aspire one day to be where we are on this day. This notion has led me to adamantly believe that the degree each of us will receive today is more than just a piece of paper that we will frame and hang on the wall. It is a lifetime source of inspiration and motivation for others. So please, during times of hardship, whether you are faced with a challenge or are feeling homesick, always listen to your intuition when it whispers, "Yes, you can." This voice that is coming from within, know that there is no limit to your capacity for greatness, and there is no barrier you cannot break. Steve Jobs once said, "Have the courage to follow your heart and intuition." They somehow already know what you truly want to become. Everything else is secondary. These words have helped me both throughout the past 2 years. And I'm here because I did follow that voice. I am glad I did. In fact, if I had to choose one positive outcome of having made it to this day, and one of the most important accomplishments since I joined the Bentley community, I will choose meeting, knowing, and working with all of you. You are and will remain the biggest and most invaluable asset Bentley has. So, to all of you, I say, class of 2023, congratulations. Yes, we have made it through. And yes, we should be proud of what we have achieved. And yes, we can now give ourselves a round of applause and say we are officially Bentley alumni. Go forward today with great pride, as you have honored yourself by achieving this remarkable goal in your life. The world awaits you. Thank you.
Thank you, Ahmed. I now call to the lectern the ninth president of Bentley University, E. LeBrent Kreit.
Esteemed honoree Stephen Kaufer, members of the Board of Trustees, faculty, staff, distinguished guests, families, and friends, on behalf of the entire Bentley community, thank you for joining us for this very special day, the 48th graduate commencement exercise at Bentley University. We are honored to have you here with us. And to the graduate class of 2023 and PhD candidates, congratulations on reaching this long-awaited milestone in your academic careers. Since you first joined the community and made the courageous decision to continue your academic journeys by enrolling in graduate school, getting to this moment here today was your ultimate goal. Today is the culmination of years of hard work. And as we all know, you did not get to this day alone. You are here thanks, in part at least, to the unwavering support of so many. Please take a moment to join me in thanking your friends and colleagues, but most especially your families, for their support and guidance throughout your academic journey here at Bentley. As you prepare to turn the page on that next journey before beginning an exciting new chapter, you'll be well served to take a moment to recognize just how momentous this occasion is. Each of you has been required to adapt to a new normal, and many of you have had to balance work and family obligations as well as your academic endeavors. In adapting to this new reality, you've demonstrated your capacity to withstand the harsh and inevitable blows of any challenges to come your way. And this is a good thing. After all, the economic marketplace and the broader society in which you will enter is largely defined by exponential change. Emergent and ubiquitous technologies will continue to disrupt how we work and interact, and the chasms across our society seem unlikely to dissipate anytime soon. Despite the challenges and uncertainties, I remain hopeful in our collective futures because I remain inspired by the communities of emerging leaders like you who are assuming the mantle of responsibility and who have not lost the capacity to be outraged at unfairness and injustice. Throughout your postgraduate experience, you have continuously shown that you are equipped with the skills, abilities, fluencies, and worldview to overcome any challenge that you may face. You have a unique opportunity here in this very moment to broaden your reach and have a lasting and positive impact on society. That potential to make substantive change is why I believe so strongly in this graduate community and the role of business in our society. I came to Bentley because I believe in the power of capitalism and business, and because a Bentley education goes beyond the traditional narrow view of capitalism and its allocative economic efficiencies, and instead focuses on the power of business to impact the human condition. I also came to Bentley because I know that we have no interest in educating the heart at the expense of the mind. Mostly, I was attracted to Bentley because of my belief in you and in your ability to go out and make a positive and lasting difference in the world. You have proven that we are up to the task, and you should be proud of how you have succeeded in the face of profound adversity. I speak for each professor, staff member, and administrator at this university when I say that Bentley is very proud to have you as a member of our community. So I hope that while you are here, you realize the transformational possibilities that result from sustained exposure to differing points of view. We have intentionally exposed you to ideas and experiences that will enable you to discern between what is right and easy, and to recognize that with the privilege of education you have just received comes a responsibility to a greater good. I know that you are ready to make your impact on the world, and I wait in great anticipation to see how you will do so. So before I conclude, I'd like to leave you with one parting piece of advice that I hope you will, at least on occasion, reflect. As you begin this next stage of your journey, I appreciate you will be focused on professional success, the right job, the right promotion, and the right salary, as these are often salient to your desired level of happiness and success. And there's nothing wrong with this. I would ask you to perhaps focus less on directly seeking happiness and success and focus more on the pursuit of meaning in your lives. Because once you identify that meaning your own true north, I can assure you that happiness and success will follow. And more critically, it will endure. McCallum Graduate School of Business class of 2023, I hope that as you transition from Bentley, that you will continue to identify and stay true to your own North Star. As you do, know that we are endlessly proud of you and will watch with great anticipation to see the powerful impact that you will have on the world and the amazing things you will achieve. Congratulations to each of you, and enjoy this day.
Thank you, President Kreit. I now call to the lectern Chair Condren to confer this afternoon's honorary degree to Stephen Kaufer.
Stephen Kaufer, innovator and explorer, builder and problem solver, entrepreneur and executive, we are proud to confer upon you the honorary degree Doctor of Commercial Science. You understand the potential of technology to enhance lives and the power of business to improve the world, hallmarks of a Bentley education. At Harvard, your analytical nature found a natural home in computer science. The company you created soon after graduation, Centerline Software, provided programming and testing tools for developers. You've been empowering people through technology ever since. Tripadvisor took off in 2000 from an office above a pizza shop in Needham, Mass. Its trailblazing concept supplied travelers with unbiased information on destinations worldwide to help them plan and book the perfect trip. When the company's early B2B model fell short, you retooled its revenue stream and championed the first-person reviews that became the differentiator. Consumers embraced your vision. The company grew to be the largest travel site in the world, providing guidance to hundreds of millions of travelers per month in 22 languages. Your determination, energy, and creativity, even through a global pandemic, hold lessons for all who aspire to lead. Social responsibility was never a missed connection. As TripAdvisor CEO, you condemned the US ban on travelers from Muslim-majority countries and raised money to help refugees fleeing humanitarian crises. You also spoke out in support of Ukraine after its invasion by Russia and raised money for relief efforts there. The TripAdvisor Charitable Foundation, which you created in 2010, has donated more than $44 million to address humanitarian challenges the world over. It advocates in particular for people compelled to leave home by extreme necessity, not personal choice. Today, we offer our deep admiration for all that you have accomplished and our full confidence that your next venture will be just as ingenious and inspiring. Therefore, by the virtue of the authority vested by the Commonwealth of Massachusetts and by the Bentley University Board of Trustees, we confer upon you, Stephen Kaufer, the degree Doctor of Commercial Science, honoris causa. We hold it both an honor and a pleasure to do so.
I now call upon Stephen Kaufer to deliver the commencement address.
Thank you, President Kreit and Chair Condren, for that warm and very kind introduction. And thank you to all of the members of the Bentley community for this terrific honor. I am grateful and truly humbled by this recognition. But the purpose, the true purpose of this day is about celebrating you, the class assembled in front of me right now, for reaching this milestone. And it is indeed a privilege to participate in your celebration and to be able to share a few thoughts with you all today. But rather than riff on your future responsibilities as titans of industry, or urge you to follow your dreams, newsflash, probably not going to be a professional basketball player anytime soon, I thought I would share with you six specific principles that I've come to appreciate in my professional and personal life with a few stories that help make them real. And hey, props to you and to me if you can remember them all by the end. Principle number one, speed wins. Speed wins is a business principle that has served me well, very well over the years. And to be clear, I am not referring to any fast cars or any illicit drug use that may or may not have occurred in my youth, but rather the constant goal to turn a business idea, a thesis, a project into an outcome as soon as possible. Whether you succeed or fail, how quickly can you learn? The faster you learn, the more shots at winning you get. I'll share an early Tripadvisor story to illustrate my point. After about a year and a half building Tripadvisor, we finally had our first major distributor, and we were expecting our first big check, maybe as much as $200,000. And look, when you're a startup and you land your first big client, it's a big deal. What we got was a check for $500. Not 200, 500. Still sends a little pang in me there. Seems we massively overestimated our partner's distribution capabilities. At any rate, our dreams of glory went poof. Our bank account said we had 6 months of runway left. In other words, we were about to go out of business. What to do? I gathered our small team, because look, we didn't have time for a big plan. We had to get moving. We came up with a handful of ideas. We argued about them, and then we ranked them as to which ones were the most likely to succeed. But I credit our eventual success not to the brilliant ideas or smart prioritization, but rather getting a bunch of totally different projects out the door in record time. The project that we ranked first was actually creating a listings business. That was our best idea, and it failed. The one that we ranked second, a direct marketing play, that failed as well. The ones that we ranked third and fourth and fifth, you know where this is going, they also failed. The sixth one, generating leads for hotel reservations, that one worked, and it worked really well, and it worked before we ran out of money. The lesson I want to impart, if we hadn't focused on going quickly, the company wouldn't have made it. The faster you go, the more chances you get to win. I scribbled the phrase speed wins on a piece of paper, taped it to my door, my office at Tripadvisor, where it remained for 22 years. Everyone who came into my office would see my focus on speed, and I would share with everyone that going fast doesn't mean producing junk. It means we can learn more and therefore help our customers more if we can deliver faster. Principle number one, speed wins. Principle number two, if it's worth doing, it's worth measuring. This phrase was literally the other sign on the door of my office, and it relates to the theme of constantly learning. It's not an original phrase, I can assure you, but it refers to the concept of figuring out what success looks like and then taking the time to understand how you are going to measure it. The beauty of this process, of course, is that when you are constantly measuring, you can be constantly learning what to do better. The fun thing is, it can be equally applied to business situations as well as your personal life. Always wanted to learn how to play the guitar? Decide if you want to do it and then ask, how are you going to measure your success? Is it hours per week practicing? Are you going to play 3 songs out of the songbook by the end of the month? Whatever it is, you have a goal and you can measure how you're doing. On track? Keep going. Not working out well? Change something up. Principle number 2, if it's worth doing, it's worth measuring. Principle number 3, embrace change. Ben Franklin is known for saying, the only things that are certain in life are death and taxes. I'd like to add the word change to that list, but with an important difference. Nobody wants to embrace death or taxes, but I'm standing here today encouraging you to embrace change. Look, it's going to happen to you, like it or not. So the question I put forth is, why not reframe the change that is happening to you as an opportunity? Whether you initially think the change is good or bad, reframe it as an opportunity waiting for you to embrace it. So here's my story on embracing change. A good friend of mine was constantly complaining about work. He liked the company, but his boss wasn't supportive, didn't provide clear direction, micromanaged too often, and to my ears, probably never should have been in management. At any rate, over our next coffee, he shares that he's really worried about his job because his boss is leaving and a new boss starts in 2 weeks. He's talking about updating his resume and leaving the company. I point out how this is actually awesome news, and he just stares at me. No, he said, you don't understand. My old boss might have been lousy, but who knows what's going to happen now? Now let's look at the situation from an embracing change perspective. He didn't like his old boss, but now his wish has come true and he gets a fresh start. Yes, there is risk with a new boss, but there's also a real opportunity to excel, to exceed expectations, and to potentially have a great mentor who can help propel your career. The facts are the same. It's just the attitude of my friend that tells the story. Do you embrace change and try to make the most of it, or worry and complain? In this case, he gave his boss a new try, and it worked out well. Now, let's make this relevant to maybe a lot of people here today. Anyone thinking about whether generative AI and ChatGPT in particular is a threat to your current or future job? Is it something to really worry about? Or are you excited about how much more productive you can be leveraging this new technology? And then ask yourself, have you tried it yet? Have you embraced this change? Or are you waiting and just worried? Why not embrace and discover how awesome this could be for you, even if there are parts you might also have concerns about? Now, I have one more story to share about embracing change. And this one is not about a job or technology change, but about pivoting an entire company. Back about 10 years ago, I needed everyone at Tripadvisor to recognize that the company had to change. Not because we were financially threatened, in fact, far from it. We were wonderfully profitable. But because I believed our core revenue stream would be challenged in the future. I had to introduce the need to change while the proverbial house was not on fire. So at the next all-hands company meeting, I launched into a speech about how competition was heating up and we needed to change our business, et cetera, et cetera. I made several key points about how we planned to do this. And then I put up a slide showing just a picture of a crying baby. Not a cartoon, but imagine a huge picture of a real baby in a diaper who looked miserable. Now, I could tell the employees were a little bit confused. They were thinking, what does this crying baby have to do with this change Steve is talking about? Well, you're a smart crowd, and you can probably guess where I was headed. I resumed my speech, I finished my rational explanation about why we needed to change, and then simply pointed to the slide and said, "And as we all know, the only person that likes change is a wet baby." Now, I'm not saying you will or should always like change, just suggesting that you embrace it and make the most of it. Principle number three, embrace change. Principle number four, don't be afraid of hard work. Maybe you've heard the phrase, the harder you work, the luckier you get. My favorite variation on this quote comes from Gary Player, a pro golfer, who responded to a fan exclaiming, "What a lucky shot he had just made," with the line, quote, "The funny thing is that the more I practice, the luckier I get." I truly believe this principle about working hard is applicable to everything we do. In our professional careers, it's pretty obvious if you are 10% more focused during the day than average, and you work 10% longer, the math says you're 20%+ more productive each week. That's huge. Learning 20% more than the person next to you compounded week over week, year over year? Think about that. Let that sink in. And then let me suggest it is equally applicable for your personal life. Take 10% more time to build relationships that are strong. Take 10% more time to do fun things with family and friends. Maybe spend less time scrolling on Instagram or TikTok or watching TV. We all do it, but these activities aren't building something. They aren't building your career, your relationship with others, your knowledge base, your reputation, your experience or insight or creativity. You aren't learning anything new. What I can promise you is that looking back, you'll value your friendships, your relationships, the shared experiences with friends and family, and you actually won't remember that hilarious TikTok or that captivating TV show. Principle number four, don't be afraid of hard work. Principle number five, own your own integrity. This one is both personal, professional and very personal. As the saying goes, the one thing you can't buy is your reputation. Warren Buffett, in his most recent shareholder letter, said that you should write your own obituary and then figure out how you're going to live up to it. I know the quote didn't originate with him, but it's great to hear it coming from a business legend. Buffett also said, look for three things in a person: intelligence, energy, and integrity. And if they don't have the last one, integrity, then don't even bother looking for the first two. And again, I couldn't agree more. No matter what you do, no matter the struggles you encounter, your integrity, your reputation, and whatever else you want written on your tombstone, let those be the guideposts for your life. Principle number five, own your integrity. I'll close with principle number six. Pay it forward, you'll find it very rewarding. Now I get it, we're all busy, we're working hard, lots of demands on our time, yet we have a lot of time. A month has 730 hours in it. How you choose to spend each of those hours is a choice. I'm suggesting that if you spend a few of those hours helping others, you will be doing a good thing to help heal our world, and your life will be richer for the effort. Volunteer for a cause, be a mentor, help someone less fortunate than yourself. Whatever you might choose to do, I predict you will find it quite rewarding. It doesn't have to be a big thing or a huge time commitment, but I believe in the biblical proverb that states, give freely and become more wealthy. Principle number six, pay it forward. To recap, number one, speed wins. The faster you go, the more chances you get to succeed. Number two, if it's worth doing, it's worth measuring. Know what the goal is and measure your progress so you can achieve it. Number three, embrace change. When change happens, try to leverage the opportunity to your advantage. Number four, don't be afraid of hard work. Working hard on professional and personal goals is a great investment. Nobody ever looked back on their life and said they wished they had watched more TV. Number five, own your integrity. You control your reputation. Live by the rules you believe in. And number six, pay it forward. You'll find it very rewarding. Make time to help others, and everyone benefits. Thank you again for the opportunity to share a few thoughts with you. And thank you to ChatGPT for making me a better commencement speaker. And once again, congratulations to all of you graduating today. I wish you all tremendous success in your personal and professional lives. And then I ask you to remember to pay it forward. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Kaufer. I call Provost and Vice President for Academic Affairs, Paul Teslick, to offer congratulations on behalf of the faculty and to announce the 2023 Faculty Awards.
Greetings and congratulations, McCallum Graduate School of Business Class of 2023. I'm honored to be with you this afternoon as we celebrate the completion of this portion of your academic journey, which has been years in the making. You've accomplished a great deal of your time at Bentley. Our dedicated faculty of teachers scholars have so enjoyed helping you achieve your goals and supporting your journey to this special day. Would all members of Bentley's faculty please stand, if able, so that we can express our appreciation for all your outstanding efforts. Thank you. I'm also pleased to share that four of our talented faculty were recently honored for their academic excellence and dedication to our students. We celebrate their achievements this afternoon along with yours. The Gregory H. Adamian Award for Excellence in Teaching was presented to Zarina Prater, Associate Professor of English and Media Studies, and Barbara Nash, Adjunct Professor of Natural and Applied Sciences. We are also proud to recognize outstanding scholarship by our faculty. The 2023 Bentley University Award for Excellence in Scholarship was presented to Pierre Berthon, Professor of Information Design and Corporate Communication and the Clifford F. Yaus Chair of Information Design, Marketing, and Strategy. Finally, the Joseph M. Cronin Award for Excellence in Academic Advising and Mentoring was presented to James Poliopoulos, Senior Lecturer of Marketing. These outstanding faculty represent just a small sample of the world-class talent at Bentley. We are pleased and proud to recognize these award winners this afternoon and thank all of our faculty for their contributions to the Bentley community.
I now call Provost Teslick to lead the presentation of the candidates for doctoral degrees.
Since Bentley University began awarding degrees in 2009, 68 students have earned their terminal degrees here. Today, we recognize and honor two more. This afternoon, these two scholars will have conferred upon them the degrees of Doctor of Philosophy in Business, and with it, all of the associated rights and privileges. While we believe that education is a lifelong journey, This degree represents the highest attainable merit available in academia. At this time, I call to the lectern Jay Thibodeau, Ray D. Anderson Professor of Accountancy and Director of the PhD program, to introduce the doctoral candidates. I also invite President Kreit to join us.
I call today's doctoral degree recipients to receive their diplomas and hoods from their faculty advisors. Doctoral candidates, the regalia you are wearing now and the hoods you will soon don have a long and storied history in the academic tradition. Today, you carry on that tradition. We shall now confer the degrees upon the candidates. I have the honor of conferring our first degree to Janae Duane, Doctor of Philosophy in Business with a focus in Information Systems. Janae will be hooded by Jeffrey Livingston, Professor of Economics. Tyler Wasson, Doctor of Philosophy in Business with a focus in Management, will be hooded by Mike Quinn, Professor of Economics. Please join me in congratulating our 2023 doctoral graduates.
At this time, we will award the master degrees. During this afternoon's ceremony, we acknowledge deserving graduate students who fulfilled their degree requirements. You have demonstrated all of the ability and determination to claim the academic recognition you so richly deserve. Of particular note, I'm honored to share that we are joined today by Bentley's first cohort of Beth Israel Leahy Health graduates who will be receiving their MBAs in healthcare management. We are proud of your achievements and thankful for your partnership. I'm glad that we could be joined by your peers and senior leaders from Beth Israel Deaconess Medical Center and Beth Israel Leahy Health. Graduates, in a few moments, you will join the community of 67,000 Bentley alumni who have gone on to do incredible things. This opens the door to many opportunities for you. At this time, I ask President Kreit to join me as we announce the graduates from the McCallum Graduate School of Business Class of 2023.
To expedite these proceedings, please hold your applause until the names of all the candidates have been read. For everyone's security and comfort, please keep the aisles clear and do not approach the stage to take pictures as it blocks the view for others. A reminder that a professional photographer is taking pictures of each graduate as they walk across the stage. Finally, out of respect for all graduates and your classmates, we ask all to remain seated until the last graduate's name is read.
Sean Doris. Emma Morgan Guccione. Hyunjin Kim. Hui M. Lee. Jue Ying Lee. Caitlin Musto. Caitlin Shea Arce. Juliana Luminosa Bayaderas. Carly Paige Bacone. Michael Charles Ford. Hannah Gershman. Jeremy Charles Glick. Esther Lubiba. Lauren Ann Lynch. Caitlin R. Maloney. Megan Yidzwicki. Kinmiat No U. Serena Fan. Julianne Elizabeth Rando. Osmani Adolfo Rodriguez. Elben Rojas. Scott Francis Tatro. Jennifer Danielle Teague. Jason Song. Elizabeth Marie Varnum. Runying Chen. Catherine Elizabeth Kenyon. Jihun Lee. Xiaoqian Chu. Hua Tao Shen. Aijing Tan. Xu Yu Ian. Iman Vasudev Alani. Fiola Azemi. Yusuf Aziz. Adelette Birlikbai. Lauren Brewster. Shobik Kumar Chakraborty. Jacqueline Colin Vasquez. Jingwei Cui. Yaodan Kui. Shweta Dakar. Harshmi Rajesh Tharod. Xing Yu Ding. Sahaj Manish Kumar Doshi. Milka Wandwasan Eshitu. Renata Gelevska. Robel Hagos. Dongni Jia. Omar Ahmed Khan. Dorina Alimadi. Jia Jia Liu. Yu Chen Luo. Feng Lu. Scott Yiliao Ma. Amza Mesbahi Awam. Monica Yeshwant Meshram. Emily Rose Mosesian. Nida Nabi. Vivek Santosh Nair. Hugh Min Nguyen. Joseph O'Connell. Luca Panzoni. Busong Park. Yaroslava Pavlova. John Rohan Putota Ignatius. Carl Jan Raska. Jessica Alejandra Resto Barreto. Ka Xuan Song. Wansham Priya Vijay Sundrani. Ashvi Talati. Konstantino Tatsis. Jia Tao Miao. Prachi Mihul Vadhani. Karen Dharmendra Vakaria. Lalitha Voruganti. Paul Nofu Vu. Jinru Wei. Ada Zama. Patrick James McGavick. Shakib Habash. Ailika Ariel Madonna Adams. Adriana Amabilino Perez. Jake Alexander Amel. Hallie Swaychan Anderson. Shreya Anugu. Tug Arnold. Alexia Asaf. Mahima Anil Bajpai. Namuna Batar. Vishal Balwani. Lauren Jacqueline Belair. Deep Hiran Bajiwala. Jose Guadalupe Campa. Estefania Chevera. Mohamed Atia. Andrea Patino. Adam Hollis Clark. Matthew Robert Carreri. Joseph James Curran. Lauren Elizabeth Dachowski. Rhea Bankam Dalal. Jayesh Desai. Rucha Rajesh Deshpande. Pranav Anant Davale. Caleb Warren Hooper Dorf. Nicholas Forcioni. Duncan Richard Fraser. Fu Wenzhou. Yona Gagani. Joseph Christopher Galante. Catherine Galvin. Noah Garcia. Andrew Nicholas Gimpetanu. Nathan Griffin. Irvis Hassa. Ahmed Himina. Brian Francis Houle. David Hunter. Michaela Sky Johnson. Prosky Joseph. Zichen Nu. Adam Russell Casatli. Emiliano Rafael Cresser Perez. Eric Daniel Krugliak. Randy Blasidio Lee. Singhi M. Lim. Hogan Scott Milheim. Jaden Andrew Mullen. Car Young Kenny Ng. Nguyen Phan Am Nguyen. Aaron Nodushani. Michael Oliveira. Parth Sanjeev Bhai Pachyesha. Nicholas Pascucci. Dhruv Patel. Amrit Kacharu. Nelly Zambulia Kasinde. Thomas Pape. Ariana Pepper Iriberi. Madhu Shri Popasani. Andrew David Quagaroli. Dhruva Rangan. Saurabh Vijay Raut. Maya Elizabeth Rose. Sabrina W. Sam. Dave Shah. Samira B. Shah. Jonathan Thomas Salamini. Alexander Starovoitov. Albert Joseph Shagru. Christopher Carl Sweeney. Bailey Michael Tafner. Bhawana Tiwari.
Robert Tringale.
Meredith Rose Ulrich. Armando Candido Guzman. Anubi Gupta. Paul Joseph Verano. Anthony Wiesenthal. Aiden Jeremy Walker. Matthew Sean Walsh. Mitchell James Walters. Christopher Ross Ward Willis. Kristen Marie White. Risa Whitehead. James Harris Wilson. Ryan Winitzer. Oscar Rufaro Miko. Xinwen Zhang Stapleford. Peter Ronald Arsenault. Nathaniel Jacobs. Goshen Nakanta. Samuel Jocelyn. Hilary Barr. Arun Bold Bhatjargal. Chris Carrera. Amy Brooke Chapman. Teresa Clark. Zachary Tyler Cohen. Rebecca Ann DeAugustine. Hala Daher. Lauren Elizabeth Dunn. Ankita Dutta. Adwait Garat. Kai E. Huang. Alexander Tehi Jin. David Abraham Just. Nrusimia Surya Sai Teja Kaipa. Karen Elizabeth Keene. Davis Herman Kent. Revant Krishna. Akhil Atluri. Cole Lampman. Melissa Moore. Jianyan Liu. Elena McComber. Soyam Sisai Mamo. Shweta Mishra. Chandrasekhar Supash Nanguda. Bonnie Nguyen. Faria Noor. Aaron Osmat. Claudia Lara. Alicia Fernanda Rodriguez Taboada. Andrea Sani. Ritika Saxena. Suzette Shante Shand Campbell. Shania Tulis. Amanda Danielle Andriano. Andrew Joseph Becker. Jenna Marie Filippelli. Joseph Michael Kiwanis. Alan Law. Jonathan Lee. Junting Chen. Chao Chung Lin. Adrian Moniz. William Edward O'Neill. Cameron Rabar. Liu Jinsa A. Rosa. Robert Condino Vos. Lauren Yuen. Courtney Taylor Allaire. Jamila Alu. Ahmed El Sayed Fauzi Amer. Jalen Rayshawn Branch. Courtney Lee Bradley. Ethan Banger. Alexander Robert Barenbaum.
Min Vodai.
Kristen Bathe. Ella Ashton Bentley. Anthony Leo Benvenuto. Joshua A. Bernstein. Caitlin Bradford. Paul James Bushy. Brian Candelario Roman. Ashvini Ganesh Kanjivaram. Molly Karen. Allison Shagnon. Jeffrey Thomas Shagnon. Le Chong. Joseph Preston Christakis. Joey Cohen. William Connolly. Molly Ann Kennedy Connors. Jessica Elizabeth Cronin. Jillian Cummins. Colin Curran. Michael Anthony DiFilippo. Matthew James Dakota. John Eusebio De Stefanis. Jake Edward DeVito. Shelby Rose DeFiore. Matthew De Gregorio. Leanne Margaret Durant. Matthew Lewis Edelman. Thomas Edwin Egbers. Antonia Fantasia. David Ferraro. Ronan Fitzpatrick. Linda Marie Forney. Manuel Franciani Casanello. Buan Guan. Adam Goodrich. Max Goody. Matthew Allen Gelman. Claudia Teresa Gonzalez Higuina. Hassan Awad Hassan. William Hartong Havens. Samantha Hope Heller. Ella L. Hillier. Kayla Simone Hodges. Tyler Holbert Catania. Mabish Hoti. Justice Hunsu. Kat Callie Ip. Benjamin Kershaw. Luke Kleppen. Kelly Marie Kokesberger. Andrew McGregor Kolb. Anthony Kuzmanides. Anthony Alexander Labate. Kirit D.R. Lala. Benjamin Lannan. Gina Salcedo Lannan. Gabrielle Laws. Leopoldo Enrique Laya del Nibleto. Alexander Layton. Olivia Lazar. Hebe Chuk Haley. Samantha Ann Baker. Josh Liu Yen. Sean Michael Mahan. Sandrine Janine Heller. Kyle James Halloran. Allison Franklin. Kelsey Claire Anderson. Rita F. Douglas. Christina Ioko. Alexander Gregory Markin. Christina Martinez Morandera. Luke Mason. Thomas James Masters. Denise M. McKenna. Aramis Malikian. Catherine Lenihan Mitkevichus. Nicholas Monopoly. Lauren Montegudo. Rebecca Ann Moore. Sabrina Morano. Despina Muratoglu. Kevin Joseph Murphy. Julia Elizabeth Nolan. Gavin Elias Olson. Sheun Oludotun Oluwole. Alexandre Onioni. Natalia Gabriela Ortega. Yoe Pan. Camilla Eva Panufnik. Amanda Page Parker. Lindsay Perry. Kushbu Patel. Alex Pietropaolo. Jean-Pierre Pinard. Romel Plaza. Michael William Poudrier. Ian Quinn. Ezekiel Joseph Quinones. Vitalia Racevich. Jonathan Rogers. Catherine Rounds. Jeffrey Charles Russo. Pedro Luis Salinas Gonzalez. Flor Sario Perez. Edward Sear. Kelly Joanna Cerna. Tia Lords Fair. Mary Elizabeth Shepherd. Brenna Scherer. Udhab Silwal. Mark Sporozik. Allison Marie Standley. Jackson Stannard. Maria Jose Taveras Soriano. Jeet Takrar. Tony Thane. Kaya Luisa Toya. Wei Tazin Ten. Daniel V. Tran. Thanasi Solius. Maria Urbina. Skyler Sustaita Vaughn. Bin Shu. Ksenia Zagorska. Maria Elena Zugravu. Cole Stewart. Marjorie Leonard Jeremy. Catherine Strickland. Joseph Chacha Mukohi. Kamika Wint. Jose Javier Pagan. Anna Carolina Maldonado. Danita Valencia Bell Huggins. Matthew Block. Lindsay Bauer Brooks. Monica Caggiano. Declan Carberry. Corinne Fairweather. Fabienne Emily Andrade. Andrea Caroline Hernandez. Ryan Thomas Hewitt. Gerald F. Ireline. Megan Kelly Dalton. S. Nicholas Kriketos. Angela Beth Lavoy. Samantha Levine Newdell. Evangelos Messaris. Sarah Beth O'Day. Bailey Beth Reagan. Jennifer Sabah. Kristen J. Skiles. Catherine Stevens. Lillian Rose Telesnik. Ashley Tran. Shanika Sanike Wright.
President Kreit, it is our pleasure and honor to present to you the members of the McCallum Graduate School of Business Class of 2023. They work diligently. They work diligently in the classroom and beyond to secure a Bentley education. With the support of the faculty and trustees of this institution, I am honored to present them to you now.
By the authority vested in me by the Commonwealth of Massachusetts and the Board of Trustees at Bentley University, and by reason of your having fulfilled all the requirements prescribed by the faculty and trustees, I pronounce you graduates of Bentley University and holders of the degrees indicated with all the related rights, privileges, and responsibilities. Graduates, the world you're entering will no doubt be filled with challenges and obstacles along the path to success, but I know that you, just as the Bentley alumni who have come before you, are well equipped with the skills and fluencies to leave your mark on the world and seize untold success along the way. Congratulations, you are now graduates of the Bentley University McCallum Graduate School of Business. Thank you all for joining us here today to both celebrate the achievements and to recognize the potential of the McCallum Graduate School of Business class of 2023. With that, on behalf of the Board of Trustees, Bentley University's 2023 commencement is now concluded.